Yes, students. Next, when you go on watching the video, the next reaction which is demonstrated is taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 test tubes are taken. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In all the 6 test tubes, what is taken? Hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid in all the 6 test tubes. Now, in the first test tube, what is added? Zinc, magnesium metal. In second, aluminium metal. In third test tube, zinc. In fourth test tube, iron. In fifth test tube, tin. And in sixth test tube, copper. These metals are added and the reactivity is observed here. So, what you see, students, here? Magnesium, then aluminium, then zinc, iron, then tin, then copper. So what you see, the reactivity goes on decreasing, because in reactivity series the metals are arranged in decreasing order of reactivity. So what do you observe? Magnesium is most reactive, then aluminium, then zinc, then iron. Reactivity goes on decreasing, then tin, and which is least reactive out of this? Copper. Okay, so the reaction you will write. So what you will observe, as soon as you add magnesium metal to hydrochloric acid, you observe gas bubbles coming out, evolution of gas. And here the rate of evolution of bubbles will be more, which shows that magnesium is the most reactive out of all these. In the second test tube also you will observe gas bubbles coming out, but it will be less vigorous than magnesium. When you come to zinc, here again you will see gas bubbles coming out, but it will be less vigorous. Rate of evolution of gas bubbles will go on decreasing. When you come to iron also, there also you observe evolution of gas, but the reactivity goes on decreasing. Rate of evolution of gas goes on decreasing. And here tin, there also gas is evolved, but after some time. Means the reactivity still goes on decreasing. But with case of hydrogen, what you observe? No reaction. No evolution of gas bubbles. Okay. So, magnesium more reactive than hydrogen. So, magnesium will displace hydrogen, remove hydrogen, take its place. So, what is formed? Magnesium chloride. Plus, which gas is evolved? Hydrogen gas. Then you write, then you balance the equation. How many hydrogen atom? 2. How many Cl? 2. This side? 1. Cl also? 1. Make it 2 by adding 2 in front. Now the equation is balanced. Okay? Next, aluminium is more reactive than hydrogen. So, aluminium will displace hydrogen, remove hydrogen, take its place. So, what is obtained? Aluminium chloride, AlCl3 plus which gas is evolved? Hydrogen gas. Whenever you write hybrid gas, show upward arrow. Balance it. How many Cl? 3. This side? 1. You have to make it 3. So, in front of the formula, you will add 3. And now this 3 is for hydrogen and also for Cl. So, and this side hydrogen, how many? 2. You have to make it 3. So, what you will do? You add your 3. So, 3 2s are 6. Hydrogen, how many? 6. And now this side hydrogen, how many? 3. You have to make it 6. So write here 6 in front. Now Cl also 6. But this side how many chloride? 3. You have to make it 6. So in front you will add 2. 3 2s are 6. Now aluminium also becomes 2. 2 atoms. And this side 1. Add here 2. Now the equation is balanced. Next, zinc. More reactive than hydrogen. Zinc will displace hydrogen, remove hydrogen, take its place. What is formed? Zinc chloride plus which gas is evolved? Hydrogen gas. Again, balance it. How many Cl? 2. How many hydrogen? 2. This side? 1. Cl also? 1. Add here 2. Now the equation is balanced. Next, iron is more reactive than hydrogen. So iron will displace hydrogen. Take its place. Remove hydrogen. Take its place. So FeCl2. Here iron, which valency we are using? 2. Plus H2. Again Cl 2 atoms. Hydrogen 2. This side 1. Add here 2. Now the equation is balanced. Next, tin. Again see here. Tin is more reactive than hydrogen because it is above hydrogen. So tin will displace hydrogen. But the reactivity is less. So it will take some time to react. Then evolution of bubbles or evolution of gas you can observe. So tin will displace hydrogen, take its place. And what is formed? Tin chloride, SnCl2 plus H2. How many Cl? How many hydrogen? 2. Add here 2. Now the equation is balanced. Next, copper. Copper, this is below hydrogen. So, means less reactive than hydrogen. So, copper is less reactive than hydrogen. So, copper cannot displace hydrogen from hydrochloric acid. So, no reaction. You will not see any evolution of gas here. So, this activity is demonstrated to show the reactivity of different metals. How the reactivity goes on decreasing. And how you come to know the decreasing order of reactivity of these metals? By seeing the rate of evolution of gas. The rate of evolution of gas with magnesium is vigorous. With aluminium also vigorous, but less than magnesium. Then as you proceed ahead, the reactivity goes on decreasing. This you know by seeing the evolution of gas bubbles. That the rate of evolution of gas goes on decreasing. And with copper you see no reaction. Means no gas is evolved, nothing is observed, means no reaction. Okay? So, you will write this balanced chemical equation after seeing the video. So, next one more is there to explain single displacement reaction.